cleaners are still up there, sir. Nobody expected you back this early.
Exactly.
Too late, Davy lad. Already taken.
Is that your youngest?
Kirsty. Off my hands in the spring. And then they can stuff this lark up their jacksies. I'm off.
I don't blame you.
Quinnan! Where's Tate? Why aren't you out of here?
Well, he's in the...
I was just checking the first aid box, sir.
You what?
Well, it's in the rule book you gave us. Charge hands duties every morning.
Don't push it, Tate. And you, Elvis. You call that clean? Dunno. What did I tell you the last time, Elvis?
You'd send me home. Wouldn't pay me.
Kid's only on a scheme.
I don't blame the boy, sir. It was my fault. He gave me his uniform last night to get washed.
You what?
And then I plain forgot to tell my daughter there was a second lot to go in.
It's the truth, I heard Jimmy say.
His kit, his responsibility.
Well, if you're going to send the boy home, sir, you'd best suspend me as well. It's only fair.
Get it clean, Elvis. And keep it clean.
He's cheerful this morning.
Who's the other?
We off or what?
That's Edward Hartley, sir. Best CR I could come up with.
What are you doing here?
DS wanted to make an early start. Give him the option of spinning Hartley's flat if he needed to.
Did he? Why's that?
Ah, well, the prison service has come up with some new information.
Well, that was quick.
It's 2 weeks late.
No, it's quick for them. So what they come up with?
Hartley assaulted a couple of prison officers, left one of them in hospital. Lost remission, but no charges brought. Ups the stakes a bit, doesn't it?
Alistair Gregg seen that?
Yeah, last night.
Well, let's hope he didn't give him nightmares.
So another quiet night, then?
Oh, we've got one that's carried over. Noise disturbance on the Cockroft. Cat's had a report that it started up again.
A party? All nighter?
Well, I don't know. It's been reported on and off throughout the shift. By the time the area car gets down there, it's quite as a grave. No one at home.
Somewhere. Sorry, Sarge. Late for parade. Got a bit of a head.
Right, Mike, I've got just the job for you.
These coloured pins are the break-ins. 31 at the last count.
And EMO's consistent?
Oh, yeah. It fits Hartley. Crowbars the doors. After that, he's pretty professional.
Oh, that's nice to know. And what's all this?
Crochet?
Well, these are the routes taken by Hartley's dust cart. Monday, Tuesday, etc. Absolute match with the break-ins.
So what route's he on today?
This one. Should be about here by now.
Reckon you're getting the mesh of it now, didn't you, Dave?
Yeah, if you say so.
Time to learn new tricks, maybe?
Hey? What do you mean?
Where is he? Where's that idiot gone? He's not doing his same job yet again, is he?
Check on someone.
Anyone to think we're social workers? Are you coming or what?
Who's he checking on?
His old ganger.
What?
Jimmy reckons he should be looked after. Old Blake keeps falling over. Jimmy reckons he might lie there one day. No one will find him.
I've told you before. Stay out of there.
So you have. Should have dumped him in the back years ago!
I want Dave pulled, Gov.
It's a bit late for that now.
Hartley had a pop at a couple of prison officers. I didn't know that when I sanctioned the operation.
You didn't know it because there was no prosecution. He just lost a few days, that's all.
What difference does that make?
Well, they obviously didn't think it was very serious, did they?
Oh, come off it, Gov. It proves he's violent.
You made a decision, Alistair. You stuck Dave in there. Now, I'll back you, but you've got to back yourself first.
We could turn Hartley's flat over, see what shows up.
Hartley is intellectually challenged, Alistair. He's not brain dead. The gear will be long gone.
What, you reckon he shifts the gear straight away? Already got to buy a set up?
Yeah, and that's who we should be interested in. I mean, you pull the fence, and the whole deck could tumble.
Have to be some fence. Most of the stolen gear's brand new.
Remind me.
Anything with a plug on it.
So ask yourself, Alistair, How does Hartley know that all this gear is in there, sitting there, brand new, waiting to be nicked? And who buys it and sells it on? Oh, no.
Come on, Polly. No one in, no loud music. Let's go.
Been reported 4 times, Mike.
What's a wind-up? Someone having a go? Put it down as NCPA, all right?
Are you the occupier of this house?
It's mine, yeah.
And you are?
Prout, Simon Prout. What's this about?
Mr. Prout, we've had reports of noise disturbance.
Yeah? Well, you're doing a pretty good job of waking up everybody on your own, aren't you?
Do you own a stereo, sir?
Yeah.
Were you playing it last night?
How could I? I work nights at St. Hugh's Hospital.
Well, is anyone else that might have been playing it?
No, I live in with Todd.
All right.
Can I have a look at this stereo, sir?
There you are.
What's this?
Timer switch.
Said to come on every hour on the hour, 15 minutes and then off again.
Look, it weren't me that started it, it was him next door.
Started what?
Well, I have to sleep during the day and he got laid off with cuts and that. It's done his head, he's gone cleaning mad. If it's not the Hoover, it's the washing machine.
And you're getting your own back by keeping him awake?
Well, the wall's as thin as paper.
You know, you could be prosecuted for that. Your stereo could be confiscated.
You can't do that.
New, is it?
Ish. Yeah, why?
Got a receipt.
Look, it's all above board and that. I've got a guarantee. See?
Is that a serial number? Sierra Oscar from 517 receiving, over.
What was all that about earlier? Bust up with Hartley.
Oh, just ignore him. I was checking up on an old mate, that's all. Plain Samaritan.
No way.
They're staying
here. I mean, you know the score. I suppose that's just domestic, isn't it? Yeah, and I'm a good fairy.
Eddie says to leave,
Daze. Why? Blake's got a workshop upstairs. Leather jackets and stuff.
Hey?
Cutting them out and that.
What, a sweatshop?
Yeah. Ain't told the council. Not paying no business rates or nothing. We're only supposed to do domestic, see?
OK, Elvis, shift them. Won't say no, will you, Dave?
I bought it off a girl. She bought it around herself.
What was her name?
Oh, I can't remember. I don't think she said.
Oh, don't tell me. You met her in a pub.
No, it's an advert in a paper.
Which one, Mr. Prout?
The local one, the freebie. Yeah.
The Gazette?
Yeah, it's a box number.
Did it not seem odd to you that somebody wanted to sell a brand new stereo?
Well, she said she won it in a competition.
And now she wanted to sell it?
Well, a lot of them do. They win these things and then they want the money instead.
So you're asking us to believe that you innocently thought you were buying some unwanted raffle prize, is that it?
Not a raffle.
Did it not occur to you that it might have been stolen?
Well, I knew it was cheap.
Right. Let's go over it again, shall we, Mr. Prout? And this time I want you to tell me everything you can remember about this lucky prize winner. Which newspaper, what date, the lot?
Don't get to keep it. I mean, I pay good money. Stereo.
Give us a hand with those, Dave. Well, come on!
Oi! You! What do you think you're doing with that?
What are you on about?
It belongs to the little boy next door. Where do you think you're taking it?
What's it to you?
You must have seen him. Or are you part of it as well?
Well, I didn't really...
Right. I'm ringing the police.
Well, no, I think it's probably best not to do that.
You saw him take it!
Are you accusing me?
Look, Eddie.
The bait was by the dustbins, darling. I mean, it looked as if it was chucked out. The lad's made a genuine mistake, that's all. Isn't that right, Dave?
Well, yeah, it was, it was by the bags.
Happens every day, this. You don't know what people want to throw out half the time. You know, now you get the comeback.
That little boy puts his bike away in the shed every night.
That's what he tells his mummy. No, I know. I've got 5 of my own, all girls. You tell them one thing, they do the opposite.
No one throws away a brand new bike.
Well, you'd be surprised. Eddie, put the bike back, will you? Out of sight. We don't want to get the wee boy into trouble.
Oh, I just thought that...
No, it's all right, darling. We get used to it in this job. Sorry to disturb you, darling.
Thanks, Jimmy. That was close.
Don't thank me. If you want to open your mouth for anything, make it an apology.
Sorry?
Look, Dave, I don't care what you and Harry get up to. That's your own business. But leave me well clear, right?
Well, I thought...
No, you didn't think. My job's on the line here. I can't afford to mess with chances like you two. Now, finish your job and let's go.
But Frank has a suspect for these burglaries.
Name of Hartley, sir.
Oh, why doesn't he just arrest him, then?
With all due respect, sir, Hartley's a professional. You could keep on arresting him till the cows come home. It wouldn't make a blind bit of difference.
Is that our decision to make, Jack?
Well, the point is, sir, Bumblebee's not about arresting the same half dozen faces. Frank's after the whole package. The fence, their mates, and the jokers who buy from them.
And that warrants putting an officer undercover, does it?
Well, normal surveillance was out of the question, sir.
An officer at risk?
Well, the team weighed up the pros and cons.
Did they? And they're all still behind the decision, are they?
Meaning what, sir?
Meaning, Jack, that if Frank is going it alone, operating a one-man band, he'd better be very confident about the outcome. Very confident indeed.
If you lose all your money like that, Elvis, here.
What's this for?
Whatever.
Ah, it was a wee bit hard, done.
Well, I thought that sort of thing went on all the time.
Is that right?
You covered for Hartley?
No. No, that was something else. You remember the fella I was checking on?
What, the old boy in the pyjamas?
Well, he was my first ganger. Oh, years ago. And he'd no qualms about making a bob or two in the side.
Well, there you go.
But he taught me never on your own doorstep. See that kid's bike? You think it was insured, do you? You think his father could afford to buy him another one?
No, not really.
Exactly. Always look after your own. That was his watch. Gave it to me when he retired.
Beauty! Well, I suppose I thought the extra cash might come in handy.
Well, we're all short, Davy boy. But there's ways and means. See this lot? The first thing they did when they went private was slash the take-home.
Make us more competitive.
What was the second thing then?
Seco, my old mates.
You learn, Elvis.
What's he teaching them that's worth spit?
It's more and more unwanted prizes these days. Classifieds are full of them. Time was you won a prize, you took it. Now they want the money instead. Pay the gas bill.
Sarge, it's just as Prout says, it is a box number.
Right.
And look, here's something else. Same box number, same description, unwanted prize, only this time it's for a hedge trimmer. That's on our list.
Looks like one of your readers had a very lucky week, Miss Townsend. Perhaps you didn't notice. You said that you keep back issues.
How far back did you want?
How far back do you go?
I mean, what does Brownlow take me for? Some kind of canteen cowboy? I mean, I would never put an officer at risk unless there was no choice.
Yeah, I know. But just make sure you're buttoned on this one, yeah?
Well, it's Alistair's operation.
Oh, come off it, Frank. You're in charge. You call the shots.
Operational decisions, sir. Risks come with the job.
Yeah, well, I think that's what Brownlow's trying to tell you. Risks come with the job.
You're a moron, you know that! Are you sick or what? What do you think? Recycling. Here, make yourself useful. Hang on to it.
We'll need it later.
It's really like a bring and buy for nicked gear. There's 20-odd adverts, all placed by the same woman, all for new electrical goods, and all on our list.
Find out who she is. Bring her in.
You ain't got a dicky player and all, have you?
Yes, hello, CID, Ackman speaking. No, he's just gone. Hold on, Dave, let me get his paper. Hold on. Right, where's it going off?
I can't be 100% sure. Hartley's getting the addresses off the boxes, the ones chucked out with a rub. I don't know. Look, I can't talk now. I'll speak to you later. All right, bye. Okay, Elvis? Everything all right?
Sir, that was Dave Quinnan on the phone.
Yeah?
He reckons it's about to go off.
Where?
He didn't say. I think somebody disturbed him.
You what?
Well, the line just went dead. It did sound urgent.
See you later, Elvis. Where are you going, Elvis? Where's he going?
There's a job on. Are you in or what?
What's in it for me?
50, maybe more.
Yeah, all right. I'm in.
Kirsty Tate, dear Greg, Sunhill.
Yeah, what do you want?
Miss Tate, I have reason to believe there may be stolen property on these premises. I have a warrant to search them.
Oh, you can't come in. I'm having a fitting.
Yeah. These are for you. Right, can you come with me, please? What are these, then? Early wedding presents.
Be quick about it, Eddie. Don't take all day.
We've done the entire route, sir. There's no sign of him.
Well, do it again.
Sir?
Well, you just can't lose a dust cart.
Don't worry about that, Nick. We need the manual. Just find the manual.
It can't just vanish into thin air, June. They must have parked up somewhere.
Having a look now, sir.
What is it with you on phones?
I was just messing about, that's all.
Oh, yeah? What are you doing here? I thought I told you to stay by the cart.
Let's just leave it, Eddie. You get out of here.
Who are you then, Dave? Are you filth or what? Am I right?
Don't try anything, Eddie.
You are, ain't ya? Scum! You're dead.
No, Eddie! No, I'll look after him. You go.
All of you.
Go, Eddie. Go.
Had you down as cleverer than this, Jimmy.
Is that right?
Well, I thought you had it all worked out. And this is stupid.
I don't worry, Dave.
Why? Why, Jimmy?
Don't ask.
I mean, you didn't need to come back here. You could have been well away.
And you would have covered for me, wouldn't you? No. I thought not.
Well, then why stop Hartley?
Oh, it wasn't for your benefit, no thing, man. It was for his. I was just looking after my own, see?
Thank you.
I don't know what all the fuss was about.
Right, bring your coat.
Look, I shouldn't be in here, nor me dad. It was Art who did the nicking.
Yeah, and you who did the fence.
All I ever did was try and use this. Stop me dad getting caught.
All right, you save it for the tape.
And the watch.
Oi, none of that!
Wouldn't listen, would you, eh? I told you it was rubbish!
Tate just didn't seem bent, that's all.
In what is otherwise a cynical day and age, yeah,
David. I'll leave it out.
Gov. Look, if it makes you feel any better, Hartley was at it long before Tate got involved, if you believe what his daughter says.
Well, what does she say?
She says that Hartley was at it from day one. Her dad only got mixed up in it later.
Yeah, but she was flogging the gear.
Well, she'd left it to Hartley. We'd have nicked him weeks ago.
Yeah. Not exactly bright, is he?
Well, that's one way of putting it.
But why Tate? I mean, it just didn't seem his thing.
Well, it wasn't. Not until Hartley came along. And then he figured out that it was only a matter of time before Hartley got nicked. And when he did, they'd both get the sack. I mean, he was supposed to be in charge.
Yeah.
He reckoned in for a penny, in for a pound.
Oh, Frank. Are you heading for a good result?
Yeah, filling up nicely downstairs, sir.
Oh, well done.
I'm buying later, if you're interested.
It's very kind of you, but I've got a meeting this afternoon. You could tell Dave Quinnan I'd like a word with him.
Yeah, I'll tell him, sir.
He's done a very good job. Showed a lot of initiative.
My old man's a dustman, he wears a dustman's hat. He wears gold blimey trousers and is in a castle flat.
What's the next job, Dave? Undercover down a sewer.
Well, it's just no excuse to be ratted, isn't it?
Yeah. Is it true what I say about the housewives?
Oh, yeah, yeah, more. Yeah, look, I'll see you down the road.
Did you have to bring Kirsty in? Was that necessary?
I was doing my job.
Feeling proud, are you? Oh, if it's any consolation to you, Davy boy, neither am I.